about a good old flood. Watching every clay turn to mud. Sling it up, slap past the doors like a new paint job on a 4x4. Girl, you're gonna have a good old time. Can't let a little bit of rain change your mind. Let your hair down, kick off in boots. Once in your life, let yourself cut loose. Gonna get money from head to toe. Clean it all, living in a swimming hole. Listen, about to get dirty in the dirty south. I'm about to show you what it's all about. Don't worry, this rowdy crowd. We ain't scared, but still throwing down. We gonna tap, light that fire. We gonna crank that country. Pass that, pass and get thirsty. Change baptized in muddy water, let me hear you say. Let it rain, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. And it's about to get dirty in the dirty south. About to show you what it's all about. Don't worry, it's a rowdy crowd. We ain't scared, we're still throwing down. We gonna tap, light that fire. We gonna crank that cuss. Pass that, pass and get thirsty.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Newton's Panthers going up against Flacco's Ravens. So, for the call of this Week 11 matchup, let's hand it over to our commentary team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we are coming to you from the heart of Baltimore, nestled between Russell Street and I-395. We're at M&T Bank Stadium. Tonight, we start Week 11 of the NFL season with a good one here between the Carolina Panthers and the Baltimore Ravens. Receiver left. Now a play fake here on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. It'll be a pickup of just two, and that'll make it second down. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Second down now after the pass completion. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Love the run right there. And when you analyzed him coming out of college, when you tried to put a grade on him, you saw the flashes while he was in school, but you didn't see the full production. You didn't see the finished product. He's a little bit raw, but you can see why people liked him. Those types of runs make you think there's plenty more there, and we'll see if that continues for him.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
And they're not going to get this one off in time. It'll be a delay. Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. To throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And the starting crew defensively for Carolina.
Kaywon Short came out of Purdue as one of the top-rated defensive tackle prospects. Now he's one of the top-rated NFL players.
Second down following the incompletion. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And they'll be in search of 11 yards here on third down. Third down, Flacco needs a decent chunk of yardage. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on third down. Now the longtime Raven punter, Sam Cook, on to punt it away. And he did get it back, I do think, yes. So no turnover on the punt, and it'll be a first down.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it. He loses it. Somehow, ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. And not great starting field position here for the offense. The end zone, Newton. And he's only able to get it to right around the three. Call it a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll bring up second down. When we look at this unit like we are now, Greg Olsen has become such a reliable target in this league.
Loves to be considered the number one option in the passing game in the offense he plays, and he lives up to it. Knows the defense is set for him, knows how to beat them.
And ready now for second and nine. They'll give it to him right up the gut. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed of the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
Throwing on third down, Newton. And that is incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target, and that brings up fourth down.
I can hear a sigh of relief all the way up here. A dangerous throw, backed up in their own territory and throwing an out route, and it got jumped, and they were fortunate it was only batted down and not intercepted.
Here's Swayze Waters now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. He'll take it at the 42. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. And a great spot to start this drive from here. On first down, Flacco. Eluding the...
Just a bunch of poor boys, daddy's girls, children of the cornfield, trying to turn a shift job into a dollar bill. We wear the muddy boots, stay true to how we're raised, ain't nothing about us fake. You know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty roads, nobody got no money, got them signed up pickup trucks, whistling at them from the country, yes sir. You know we're straight out. John Deere junkies getting funky to some old hang. Nothing been stuck in the mud that we can't hook up to rusty chain in the sun or in the rain. Yeah, it's the kind of thing you know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty road. From the country, yes sir. You know we're straight out of that long week working now. Everybody wanna party. Straight out of moonlight, straight out of moonlight. Woo! You know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty roads. Nobody got no money, got them signed up.
everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Two teams will need their quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today. It's Newton's Panthers going up against Flacco's Ravens. So, for the call of this Week 11 matchup, let's hand it over to our commentary team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Inner Harbor at M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland. Tonight, we start Week 11 of the NFL season with a good one here between the Carolina Panthers and the Baltimore Ravens. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Well, it certainly appears that they had a pretty good formula how to combat waiting around all day to play a night game. Came right out, smacked them, and gained big yardage because it's tough for a coach. How much time do you spend with a team? How much time do you meet? How often do you actually eat meals? Do you get them out of the hotel? It's a tough, tough task to have them ready to play a night game when they've had to sit around all day, usually watch other people get ready to play as well.
And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Star Latulele in on the tackle. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
Ready!
Flacco here on second down. Deep drop. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Now, that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Again, zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you make curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That one goes for 24 yards.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
One of the toughest things for an offensive lineman to learn is the ability to get in space and hit people who are moving targets. And linebackers are not easy ones to hit because they know how to move, juke, and make you miss. And that's exactly what he did on that play. A nice play for the defense.
It's already second and 12. The defense hoping to push them back more. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On second down, Flacco to throw. And his throw is incomplete. And the starting defense here for the Panthers.
Charles Johnson off the edge. A long day for any offensive tackle.
And here comes play number six on this drive. So now at third and 12 with an extra defender here in the secondary, a nickel look. Now Flacco, and he fires one that's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Going to give this time to the tailback. And down to the 44, 5 yards that time. The linebacker C.J. Mosley in on the stop. Kelvin Benjamin has to be a feature of this offense that's on your screen now.
Definitely the number one receiver, a huge target with some speed. It's almost like go-go gadget when he goes up to get the football. No matter how you defend him, he can go just a little bit higher.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. They'll try the air now with Newton. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. And here are the Raven defensive starters.
From the time he entered the NFL, Terrell Suggs has been a load to block for anyone. His ability to get upfield and make plays in the backfield, almost unparalleled.
From the gun on third down, Newton. He dumps it off to Artis Payne. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
There are a lot of tough routes to try and cover. When you see a runner come out of the backfield and run this angle route, looks like they're going to the flat, and then they put their foot in the ground and cut back sharply inside. Not easily covered, and then when they catch it, good momentum built up by them as well.
And able to pick up the first. No gain on the play there, second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Here's Newton now on second down. Benjamin with it over the middle. And he's brought down. 16 yards to the 16 and a first down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
And he takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Second down following the run. To throw on second down is Newton. This will be caught at the 2. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. A little tough on the secondary there. End zone defensively. Quarterback had time to survey and find a spot.
And if you want to change things up and put a little more pressure on him, you can go to man coverage. Everyone matches up and send more pressure. But you can also do it out of zone coverage if you're worried about what's going to happen on your back end. Send someone else, drop someone else out of the line. The old zone blitz could come into play to try and get that pressure on the quarterback.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina. A great effort there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. And his kick is good. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And the kicker commits the kicker's cardinal sin. He kicks it out of bounds. First and 10 here for Flacco. And on the left side, he's got Witten. A gain of 6 there on first.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Second down and 4. And he'll give it here to his running back. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. And he'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Luke Kuechly combines speed, intelligence, toughness, puts it all together. It makes plays like one we just saw there. He may not be a big-time blitzer, but boy, he knows how to pursue straight ahead and make plays in the run game.
And the offense in that middle ground here on third down, 5 yards to go. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Third down, Flacco from the gun. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Give him 8 yards on the play, and they pick up the first.
It's a nice job hitting him on the angle route there. Coming out of the backfield, cutting sharply across the middle. And that's good timing between the quarterback and his receiver.
Effective third down play to move the chains. Here's Flacco, over the middle here to Brown. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. Second quarter now, Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the Ravens who have the football. They've got it second and 4 to start things out. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. They'll put 2 receivers left, 2 to the right. Second down, Flacco now. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down. So nothing there on the screen that time.
That means all that great acting they tried on offense went for naught, didn't it? Because you have to try and influence them. Make them think that you're doing something else. Make them think that they can get to the passer by letting them by and then setting up the screen and getting downfield. Didn't happen at all. Give a lot of credit to the defense for not tumbling to that one.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Here's Flacco. And this is going to be incomplete. Kamar Aiken, the intended receiver. And it's 4th and 4.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
Now Justin Tucker. He has hit from 61 in his career, so he has the leg for this. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And that one will be no good. He never had it online. It's well wide to the left, and this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, set this one off target.
Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
On 2nd down, here's Newton. Frenches with a catch over the middle. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
The defensive line controls the offensive front the way we just saw there. It doesn't allow any of the offensive linemen to leak downfield and get to the linebackers and block them on the second level. You end up with the type of play we just saw. Linebackers didn't have to fight anyone off. Didn't have to knock anyone to the side. Didn't have to elude anyone trying to block them. They just saw the play, ran to the ball, and finished things off.
Here's Newton now on second. And down he goes. A sack. They sack him back across midfield at about the 48-yard line.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and it can often hit big. But sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, that allows your blitzers to get there.
And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. They practiced this all week. Pretty clear it paid off there. Threw it downfield, made it look relatively easy.
And it always comes a little bit easier when you've practiced it and tuned things up and you're confident in what you're doing now. They felt very, very good about their plan, and we saw the execution because the confidence of the players was there.
Now a handoff here to his running back, and he's going to bring this one down to right about the 20-yard line. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Now it's Newton. And he whips that one incomplete there. He was looking for the connection with Devin Funchess. And it's third and short. This will be play number 7 on the drive. 3rd and 1 yard. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
What immediately flashed through my mind was 3rd and 1. It has to be a physical run. It has to be that physical play. Get what you can, be your own blocker if you have to, but don't end up losing yardage on that play. That's just an absolute no-no. Can't happen, except we just saw it. It did, and it really changes the course of the game.
Throwing on 3rd down, Newton. And he gets it to Funchess complete. And he's able to pick up the 1st down before he's tackled right at the 10. And now the passing game here in the 2nd quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to bull his way down to about the 1-yard line. A good red zone run there, 9 yards, and it'll be 2nd and goal. That's what they wanted out of that 1st down play. Run it down there. Now they're knocking on the door.
The only thing that would have been better was getting it in. And now they can do whatever they want because they've got confidence on their side. Line up quickly and go, or savor it a little bit, but I run right back at them.
Offense looks to punch it in here from the one on second and goal. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. Now the Panthers get set, third and goal.
And the defense has to account for Cam Newton on this play.
Third and two, Newton. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Kamale Correa in there to drop it for a four-yard loss, and it'll be fourth down. Fourth down, and here's Graham Gano now in the field goal unit for the Panthers. This is a fairly straightforward 22-yard short attempt. And Gano's kick is right through. And the lead moves to 10-0. And Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height. Sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
They'll give it to him right up the gut, and he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. And a big face mask penalty here, 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
First and 10, and Flacco looking to throw. It's complete to Brown, right side. 20, 10, and all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Corey Brown, his second touchdown on the season. And the Ravens are able to show off their quick strike ability. Justin Tucker for the extra point. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And onto the field, here come the Panthers. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that'll help him in contract time. You could have kicked that one too.
Super tall.
A solid gain of 15 yards and the sticks move.
The screen was executed and completed, but where's the worry on the play? How many times is a quarterback going to get hit? Because offensive linemen have to do an acting job of making sure it looks like they're whiffing on blocks. But you got to slow them down a little bit, because if you don't, that's a lot of big guys coming at your quarterback in a big, fast way. And boy, you can get hurt.
Now Newton on first down. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
First down throw for Newton. Caught left side by Funchess. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does. And the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think...
Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. On first down, Newton. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Red zone opportunity. From the red zone now, Newton. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And here he'll get it down to the 7. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it 2nd and a foot or so.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down.
I think a lot of people are a little bit surprised there that they ran the draw after that successful pass play previously. But the thought process had to be, maybe we can catch them rushing the passer and hit something big with the running play.
Newton looking to throw on 3rd and 1. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Their dangerous wide receiver in the final seconds of the first half. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. It's good to make it 17-7. Following the touchdown here to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. They come out here in the eye. Now they try the right side here. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Larry Ridley. He's standing by with our EA Sports halftime report. Larry?
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Newton now on second down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage here back at the 41. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackle was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Second down, offense behind the sticks here, second and 13. To throw on second down is Newton. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he is taken down deep in Baltimore territory. A huge play there on the screen pass. 49 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Auburn alum, Artis Payne, and able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. A good run of 6 yards there gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
They'll run it now out of the gun. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now the Panthers get set, third and goal.
And the defense has to account for Cam Newton on this play.
They come out here in the eye. No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal?
They gain nothing, and all they need are inches. Usually we put this on the offensive line, but sometimes it's the quarterback's fault as well on the sneak. You've got to get low and burrow.
Usually we talk about O-line surge, their D-line surge leading to fourth. So they take it all the way to the 1 yard line, but in the end they opt for three.
I know if this was a video game, they never would have gone for the field goal because, Brandon, who kicks field goals in video games? But you've got to make sure you get points. And that was as easy a three as you can get.
You kick field goals in video games. That's who kicks field goals in video games. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Ravens offense getting ready now for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half, Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. So a loss of five, and it'll be second down.
When you lose that kind of yardage on a pass play, you often expect it to be a sack. But that wasn't the case there. They completed the pass. Probably would have been better off just dropping the football and making an incompletion as opposed to catching it and losing that kind of yardage.
So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. Flacco here on second down. His throw incomplete. The intended receiver was Corey Brown. And that takes us from second to third down.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Now Flacco trying to lay one up deep. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's the safety, Kurt Coleman. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line. So their woes on offense continue. That's the second pick thrown here in the third quarter.
And we know it was ill-advised. But that was an opportunity to help them get back into the game. Instead, he throws another interception, and now their task is even tougher.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
They'll come out in the pistol. And they'll go on the ground. And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll lead here to a third down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Throwing on third down, Newton. And he finds a man, it's Olsen. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add it a little extra at the end with a short run.
Time as he's taken down right around the 26. Elvis Dumervil there on the tackle.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone, but these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
So second and nine, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here.
Second down. Here's Newton. A hit as he throws there. Incomplete. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there. And it's third down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Here's Newton. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. 15 yards through the air and a first down. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
And now the offense operates in the red zone. They'll run it on the toss. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game, and with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
It's a loss of 2, now third down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
Here comes the 8th play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. To throw is Newton. And that'll be caught. Panthers touchdown. It's Benjamin with a grab. Kelvin Benjamin, his second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. Gano for the extra point. And that one pushes the lead up to an even 20. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm hearing my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And on the left side, he's got Witten. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
5 yards left for the offense. It's second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Looking for 2 yards here on third down. Flacco finding time. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position. Now a handoff here to his running back. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it's going to make it 3rd down and 6.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
Defense sinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on 3rd and 6. Artis Payne. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, some point you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
So now the field goal unit trots out there for the 3rd time tonight from the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And Gano's kick is right through, and that will extend their lead even further. So it's 3 more points, and that widens things out even further here in the 4th.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the 3 whenever you can.
After knocking through the field goal, here's Gano back out there now for the kickoff. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Ravens offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. 2nd down, Flacco now. And a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. They'll give it to him right up the gut. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a 4th down. And this defense continues to give them fits. They just can't get really anything going on the ground, can they?
I love the theme that you just brought up. This defense has been tough all game long against the run. We just saw another example of it there.
Taking it about the 16. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. Carolina getting set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But you also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
That's going to go as a loss of 1 yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be. But we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
Yes, sir. Yes,
Here's Newton now on second down. And the tight end Olsen, right side. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. He's got size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's third down for this offense. Newton to throw. And that is incomplete.
And I think the end result, knocking the ball away, was a product of understanding where they were on the field, understanding how many yards they needed to pick up the first down, and tightening their coverage accordingly. Gave them no gaps, no spaces, no real air in which to catch the football and end up making a really nice play.
Here's Swayze Waters now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. And that is very well done there, as this will be marked out of bounds at the 5-yard line. The Ravens offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game. When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10.
Set, ready! Ready!
Throwing here on 1st down, Flacco. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. It's the safety, Kirk Coleman. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
A gain of 3, 2nd down.
Really held them to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at them. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
Seven yards to go on 2nd down. Play clock winding down. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Face mask penalty, and Charles, you were a defender. You know sometimes in the heat of the moment, it's hard to keep your hands away from that face mask.
Sometimes you just get out of position as a defender when you're trying to make a tackle, so you end up flailing away, and your hand gets into the wrong spot.
They come up in an offset eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And they'll run it here. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And still about 3 yards shy of a 1st as the 4-yard pickup brings it to 3rd down.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Fourth quarter, two-minute warning about to hit, and it looks like they're going to get one more play in.
It'll be interesting to see what they try and do on this play. Do they try and take a shot, or do they just try and get to the two-minute warning?
Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. And now the Ravens are going to take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So now off goes Newton, and on comes the kicker, Graham Gano. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Gano's kick is right through. And that will extend their lead even further. So give them three there. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach. But it kept the offense out of the end zone.
After knocking through the field goal, here's Gano back out there now for the kickoff. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build
on. Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Decent chunk of yardage still left here. Second and seven. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
Set, move, 45.
Flacco to throw here on third down. He gets it to Brown, complete. A pickup of 11, and it moves the chains.
Well, we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? Mike will hear about that from him soon.
Now Flacco, and incomplete there. A nice hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. And now they're in the hurry up.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one. You know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive linemen, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
On second down, Flacco to throw. Backing up. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And that'll put us within three scores as it becomes now a 23-point game. So despite the huge deficit, they're going to keep fighting. Here comes the onside kick. Oh, the Ravens say they have it. They do have it. Great job by the kick team there to get the football, but also don't forget about the man that started it, the lonesome kicker himself.
I love that you brought him into it because he doesn't get nearly the attention he deserves. Oftentimes, it's only when it's negative. In this case, he created a positive play for his team.
And barring something unforeseen, this will be the last play of the game. They'll come out in the pistol. Now it's Flacco firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. But, Charles, it's great to win at home in the NFL. When you win on the road, it's a little extra special, isn't it?
It is because, let's face it, in most cases, you're not expected to go on the road and win in the National Football League. It just doesn't usually.